Hi, I'm David Gonzalez, and today I want to show you how you can use Autopano Giga in combination with Mistika VR to improve the quality of your stitch and also simplify it. First thing we have to do is to load the footage. This footage was shot by Pablo Ballester, who has also been involved deeply in the development of this feature. Just drag and drop into Mistika VR, and we'll get 5 lenses in this case. Let me rearrange them like that. And we can see that this was shot on a Zcam S1 hanging off a drone, but Pablo has also added an extra GoPro on top of the drone to be able to get a clean plate of the sky. The first 4 cameras are in sync, but the GoPro will most likely not be in sync, so let's fix that first. Let's move into a nice sync point, looking at the top cameras. Okay, so somewhere around there. When he claps his hands, I'm just gonna click on sync, audio sync, and I'm gonna reduce the set's length because it isn't as bigger, to 200. Click OK, and it gives me a sync offset only for the 5th camera, which looks good. Let's go back to where he claps. They're not perfectly in sync, but we can now improve it with the manual offset controls to the right of the camera. So that looks in sync now, and we now have to jump to a different frame in which we have good control points to prepare the initial stitch. So let's wait until Pablo leaves the camera, the drone starts flying. That looks like a very good reference point. Before sending it to Autopano Giga, we just need to check on one option. Go to File, Options, and make sure that, at least for the first time, you get the Show window to configure external stitch applications. Hit Apply, and now we can go to Stitch, External Stitch. We select the Use Autopano Giga, and if you want, you can click on the Do Not Show this window again. As soon as we click Continue, Autopano Giga will launch and we load the 5 snapshots. And there are a few settings that we could change here. First of all, in the image properties, we're gonna force it to be a fisheye and also set the focal length to 10 mm. It doesn't need to be a perfect match, but somewhere around the focal length that we're using. After that, we want to change the detection and optimization settings. For detection, we're gonna activate the manual settings, set the quality to high, and increase the number of control points to 150 or even more if you want. As well, under optimization, we want to modify the optimization scopes and particularly the focal and offset. We want to drag the slider all the way to the left so that the focal and offset parameters are optimized separately per lens. After that, we can click on Detect. And then we can edit and improve as much as we want. First of all, I'm gonna rotate it. And if we look here in the list, Autopano hasn't found any control points on the GoPro, but we can add it and search for them ourselves. If we click here in the Add Images, we just need to load the image that is missing and then go into the Control Points Assistant. Select 2 of them with Control and start dragging around, so that area matches that one, and it will try to place control points in there. Click on Optimize after you added the control points. And I'm now just quickly repeating this process in all the other pairs of cameras. Once we've added control points to all the different images, we can close this and go to the preview. Let's change it to ISO, and we can see how the sky covers most of the sky. We don't need to do any more here. We can continue our work in Mistika VR, save it as in the same folder in which I have the rushes, and we can move back into Mistika VR. Now we just need to load the project with import stitch, go to the VR media folder in which I saved it, and load calibration. We can see already how everything matches. The sky matches perfectly. The brightness is slightly different, but we can fix that now. Let's say by just manually dragging the brightness slider on this camera until it matches. And after that, we may want to increase the feather. Let's show the feather as well. So we're gonna increase the feather and we're gonna straighten the horizon by clicking Alt and finding two vertical lines like the two on this building. So the second one on that should be straight. And last, we can activate optical flow to deal with the parallax issues. As you can see, as simple as that, we can load an Autopano Giga project into Mistika VR. I hope you enjoy the video and thanks for watching.